The Ben Davis and Kelly K Show podcast on demand.
All right, setting the bar, small examples, big examples of what not to do. Listen, we all got up this morning and we're like, man, I don't necessarily want to go to work. I don't want to do another 9 to 5. You know, I don't want to have to deal with customers maybe. You know, it's just not what I'm wanting to do today. Well, keep that in mind with this setting the bar. If you could manage to make it through the day without staging your own elaborate kidnapping to get out of work, you're doing okay.
Wow.
Yeah.
That took a lot of effort.
Yeah. Brandon's only 19, so he hasn't been on the job force that long. And so maybe benefit of the doubt, he doesn't know how. He doesn't possess the life skills yet of calling and talking to his boss and saying, hey, I'm going to have to take a sick day.
Oh, hey, you said life skills. I feel like there's a few more life skills he's missing.
All right, so here's
he is automatically at 19 going to go to, well, I'm going to fake my kidnapping so I don't have to go in today.
All right, so, sorry, if this is a spoiler, I apologize, but Police Commander Mark is going to walk through Brandon's failed, quote, made-up kidnapping attempt.
He informed us that he, at first, stuffed a bandana in his mouth. He took off his own belt and bound his hands with his own belt.
Okay, he bound his own hands with his own belt.
A little bit of a magician trick.
That's right. A little impressive there.
And laid on the ground and scooted out near the side of the road where somebody could see him.
Yeah, so he's laying on the road in the hopes that someone's going to find him. Said that a couple guys masked had kidnapped him, hit him on the head, knocked him unconscious, and then he woke up here.
Informed us that he was hit in the head and stuffed in a car in front of his home.
Yeah, again, this is Police Commander Mark explaining Brandon's plan. So sorry if this is a little bit of a spoiler for you. Yes, he did get picked up by police for this.
But when we located video surveillance of in front of his home, we were able to see no such thing.
Oh, no. You mean video
He had a video surveillance system
that
was going to watch him walk himself out to the curb.
Yeah. He said the whole incident occurred because of a large amount of money his dad had hidden around town. That, I'm sorry to say, was also made up.
Dang it, there's not a little scavenger hunt we can go on to find the money?
There is not a shred of truth to any of this. The only truth was that Brandon was going to be missing work at the tire factory that day.
He admitted fabricated the story because he didn't want to go to work.
Yeah.
Okay, well, so then I tell you what, though. He did succeed in getting off work.
Yeah, because the tire factory fired him. And
dang.
He got fired, and he also got arrested on suspicion of false reporting to police. So, yeah, you know, again, Brandon probably doesn't have the life skills. Maybe he didn't have someone say, hey, you know what, if you don't feel like going to work, you know, a lot of times employers give you sick days. Just call and tell them you got to take a sick day. You know, maybe
that would be a lot easier. I mean, the classic bandana in the mouth, though. What a nice touch.
What a touch.
Really adds authenticity.
I know. He had the story, too. He had quite the story. So, again.
Oh, yeah. Backstory. The whole thing. Yeah.
Yeah. I know you're probably sitting there, even driving right now, going, I don't even want to go to work today. Probably not the best idea to fake your own kidnapping in some sort of weird, elaborate scheme because your dad hit a large amounts of money all around town to get out of work today.
You know what? Yeah, you may have to go to work today, but your day is guaranteed to end up better than Brandon.
Yeah, setting the bar.
Guaranteed.
On 99.7 DJX.